Hello, 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 and welcome to Business English 14. My name is Steve Ford, and many of my online students, my business students, they're asking me about business letters and how to write business emails. And straight off, I want to point out that there has been a huge shift from more business letters, from letterheads and dates, office addresses, to register. That is the level of formality. Now, most letters sent out by post are now used only for formal business proposals. So it's important not to mix the format of a letter and an email. Now, I have a little anecdote regarding a message I got to show you how someone can mix up the letter format and email format and cause great confusion. So here we go. So I'm checking my inbox. This happened about a year back. And I see this message from a potential student. So I open it up, I click on it, I open it up, and the first thing I read is, "Hello, dear." Now, that's something my grandmother or maybe my mother would say to me as a term of endearment. Yeah, my mother might still say that to me. Something loving like, "Oh, hello, dear," not too far from "Hello, sweetie." "Hello, honey." So I think to myself, no. This guy must have got things mixed up, and he really wants to say either "Hello, Steve," or "Hi, Steve," or a more formal "Dear Steve." So I let it slide, and I sent this guy an email back saying, "Okay, let's set up a time to talk on Skype. No problem." So then I get a contact request, and the guy's last name is Passion. So I sat on that contact request for days. So I say to my wife, "Dear, I have this contact request from a guy who calls himself Mr. Passion." And he started off his email message as, "Hello, dear. Should I add this guy to my contact list?" She laughed and said, "You know what, Steve? I think that you should add this guy to your contact list. I think he got mixed up about how he should write his email." So, in fact, his last name was Passion, and it was just a coincidence. And it ended up that when I actually did talk to this guy, I put on this macho poker face. You know, my TOEFL grammar face. Like, "Hi, how are you today? Great meeting you. Thanks for contacting me. Let's get down to business." "Hello, dear." Okay, anyway. It turned out that the guy had made a huge mistake, and I pointed out this mistake, and he was very thankful. So let's take a look at how to start a business email. "Hi, Steve. It was great meeting you, and my boss has given me the go-ahead. Could you send me a budget proposal? I will be holding a meeting with the board of directors tomorrow, and if you can get the budget proposal to me by tonight, I will have an answer for you sometime on Wednesday in the AM, or in the AM. Roger." Now, 9 out of 10 times, you're going to use "hi." For those who are not used to writing business emails, this might come as a bit of a shock, since business emails in other languages can be more formal. Right, so can you use "hi" with confidence, even when you're emailing your boss? And the answer is yes, you can. On the odd occasion, I will get an email from someone that will start with "Dear Steve" or "Dear Mr. Ford." Now, everything isn't necessarily going to be spelled out in a potential client's email. Giving someone the go-ahead means that they can proceed to the next step. Holding a meeting is more formal than saying having a meeting. Here you can see a mix of formal and informal, like I say in all of my other business videos. North Americans love to mix formalities when it comes to business. Get, yes, the verb that everyone loves. In this case, get the budget proposal to me means send the budget proposal to me. You can add that to your Get dictionary. Wednesday in the AM, what does that mean? It means that it's in the morning. That's quite simple. Only saying AM is faster than morning. Try it. AM, morning, AM, morning. See, you just saved yourself 0.5 seconds of your workday. My fifth and final point is how to sign off on an email. You really need to look at the context of the situation. If you want to show a certain level of respect, you could sign off regards or best regards. Though, if you're dealing with a company rep who is in a position where you need them and they don't need you, then you might just see them sign their name at the bottom of the email. That happens quite a bit. Usually sign-offs are like regards or best regards, and they will fall to the wayside after a few emails as it becomes redundant. So you don't need to use it every single time you're in contact with someone. In Business 15, I'll be going over my reply to Roger's request for a budget proposal, and I hope I've helped you brush up on your business email skills. Have a great day, and see you in cyberspace. Bye-bye.